Okay, so Yankeeprepper was doing a video on fantasies, people's fantasies that they're going to be able to take on the United States Army. And he mentioned that if you can't pass the basic military test for basic training, how can you compare yourself to an Afghan rebel? And that makes a lot of sense to me. So not that I would ever compare myself to any type of insurgent or any type of rebel or even claim that I can take on a military, but I thought it'd be kind of interesting to try to do the push-ups. I'm providing a little DVD commentary here. But I'm going to do it not the way that you usually get it on DVDs, but like a really honest version of it. You know how actors say, oh, he was such a pleasure to work with. You know, some of them really want to say, that guy is such an asshole. I mean, I don't ever want to work with him again. Well, here you go. He needs to sit his ass down. That's what. Stop eating those little Debbie cakes. Yankeeprepper, you might want to hold off on sending me out into the field. Yeah, I was a little bit shy of 31. Let's see what happened the second time I did it. Oh God, here we go for a sequel. I mean, I hope they paying him well. You know that's why he's doing it, because, come on, the sequel is always worse, and judging by this, I'm right, it's always worse. I mean, well, see, yeah, okay, that was a little bit better. I mean, I didn't take that much of a break in between the push-ups, so maybe I should have gave myself some more time, but... yeah, I don't think I should be in a squadron. I definitely don't have delusions of grandeur about being a G.I. Negro or something, or G.I. Joe, excuse me. No, I think I had it right the first time. Anyway, here's something. It's a physical activity that I definitely need to do more of because I actually like it. As the director, my first pick was Mr. Lock and Load, because he looks like he can do a lot of push-ups. Instead, I got stuck with this guy. Don't you hate it when directors say on those commentaries that, oh, this actress was my first pick? Yeah, right. I mean, how often could that actually be true? No, we couldn't get Mr. Lock and Load for budget reasons. We got stuck with this guy. It's really funny because a lot of times they'll repeat the same lines, such as... he's an actor's director, he really knows what he wants, and all this stuff, it's like they're reading from the same line. I mean, I know they're actors, but when you're BSing, you should at least come up with your own original BS. You know? There's no way that everybody gets along, and I hate it when you get really bad DVD commentaries. Something I really want to hear, something interesting. You know, I want to hear an actor say something like, you know, and after this scene, I almost had an overdose in my trailer. While I was having sex with my co-star, who was also married to the director. So what do you think about Yankeeprepper's idea about physical training? I definitely need a lot of physical training. But I was thinking, do you really need that much physical training if you're going to be a hit-and-run type of person? Well, I mean, I guess so. I mean, if you're going to be hitting and then running, you might want to learn how to actually run. But, no, I'm not really anticipating anything quite like that. I mean, hopefully I won't have to put myself in a situation where I'm going to have to need a battle rifle. Although, it would be cool to have an AK-47, but I'm not really the running gun type. I'm more like the guy who's sitting in the bushes watching everybody else run a gun. You can give me the 30-06 rifle or something. I like that job a lot, just sitting there and engaging, but from a distance.